Hello everyone, I'm Anisha Malde from the Amazon Developer Relations team. And today I want to talk to you about using React Native to build for our Amazon devices running Fire OS. Since Fire OS is based on the Android open source project, you can build with React Native to utilize your existing JS or React skills to easily target our devices without having to learn a whole new technical stack. So follow along to see how to get up and running with React Native to target our Fire devices. In order to start developing for React Native, you will first need to set up your developer environment. You can find the instructions in the React Native developer portal. Follow the workflow for your specific environment. Since I have a Mac, I will run through that workflow, and we will target the Android OS since, as mentioned, Fire OS is based on the Android open source project. The first thing you will need to do is install dependencies, starting with Node.js and Watchman. Node.js is the JavaScript runtime, and Watchman triggers actions when files are changed, allowing React Native to automatically rebuild the JavaScript bundle. Next, you will need to install the Java Development Kit and export your Java home variable. Finally, we will need to set up the Android development environment. The first thing we will do is install Android Studio, the IDE used to compile and run your Fire OS apps locally. Next, we will install the Android SDK, and finally, we will configure our Android home environment variable. Once that's done, we will need to configure our Android devices. Let's start with our emulators. Opening up Android Studio, I'm going to click More Actions to access the Virtual Device Manager. As you can see, I already have a phone, so let's go ahead and install a tablet device. I'm going to pick the medium tablet and install it with the image that I already have. Once that's done, I'm going to install a TV emulator. I'm going to pick the 1080p one, and again, I'm going to install it with one of the system images. And both my devices should be available now. Now we are ready to start building our app. We're going to use the Expo framework as it enables an easier and faster developer experience. In the terminal, we're going to create a new React Native project with the create Expo app command, calling it Fire Tablet Demo and using a blank template. NPM, the node package manager, will install all the dependencies needed. Once that's done, let's go back to Android Studio and run our tablet emulator. This will launch it. Now, we can cd into that Fire Tablet Demo folder and run our app using the command npm run android. This installs the app using Expo Go. And there we go, there's our app running. You can then use an IDE of your choice to modify your code. I'm going to use Visual Studio. As you can see, it's a very simple template. Let's go ahead and just quickly change what this text says to running on tablet. Once you save, this should immediately reflect in your emulator. Now let's set up our physical device. The first thing we need to do is ensure that USB debugging is on. Head over to the settings menu and scroll down to device options. If you don't see the developer options menu, click on about Fire Tablet and click on the serial number 7 times. Now go back to developer options and ensure that USB debugging is on. Now we can connect our Fire Tablet to our laptop via USB. To ensure it was correctly connected, run the command adb-devices-l. And this should list the tablet device. Now let's cd back into that Fire Tablet folder that we created. Then we can run the command npx expo run android and specify that it should run on our Fire Tablet device. Once it's finished building, press A to run it on Android. And there we go. There's our app that was running on the emulator running on our physical tablet. Let's move on to TV. The process is very similar, but we're going to use a TV template. Using the command npx create expo app, we're going to call it Fire TV Demo, and it's going to use this with TV template. This uses React Native TV OS, which is a fork of React Native with additions for TV support. Now, just like with a tablet, let's run our TV emulator. Now, we can go back and cd into our Fire TV Demo folder, and again, just like with the tablet, we're going to run our app using npm run android. Once it's finished building, you will see your Fire TV app running on the TV emulator. As you can see in the package JSON, it imports React Native from React Native TV OS, so you get all the benefits of the added TV support. Now let's move on to our physical device. I'm using a Fire TV stick. Now, just like with the tablet, we need to ensure that USB debugging is on. If you don't have your developer options, if you click about and you click Fire TV Stick 7 times, this will enable developer options. Let's just ensure that USB debugging is on, and there we go. Now, again, just like with tablet, we're going to use the command npx expo run Android with our device name, and this will run our app on the TV. Once your app is running, let's go ahead and just verify that fast refresh is working. I'm just going to go ahead and change this text. And there we go. For more information on how to build TV apps with React Native, you can check out the guidebook we wrote with CoolStack, Mastering the Big Screen. You can also follow us on dev.2, where you can find more information on building with React Native for our Amazon devices. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, you can find me, my team, and the rest of the Amazon developer community at community.amazondeveloper.com. See you next time.